First motivation comes from my husband. So with a 3-month-old baby, I did my master.
What are the key things one requires to be an educationist?
Of course, you have to have a good sound knowledge of your subject.
In a country like India, where some of the Indian women are much neglected, there are some who have really soared high, thanks to such powerful ladies that they have faced struggles, challenges, and yet made their way to the top. And today, we have such an educationist with us who has proved that being a leader is not beyond their ken. Let us welcome Ms. Anuradha Handa, principal of GD Goenka Public School, Gurgaon, who is a distinguished educator and administrator, and who believes that each child is unique and that the educational system should facilitate and address the uniqueness and individuality of each child. Hello, ma'am.
Thank you.
Hello.
Please have a seat.
So, you're the principal of a school, huh?
Yes, I'm the principal of...
I am naturally scared of meeting principals.
If you would come to my school, you wouldn't feel the same.
You know, when I went for my kids' admission
to
a school and we had to meet the principal, and I don't know why I am scared. When I have PTA meetings of my kids, I get scared. I don't know why. I think it's a natural from the childhood. You're always scared. So why is being a principal considered so scary?
I agree with what you're saying, because that's how it has been, that, you know, the principal, in order to be able to have a better control on her organization, tries to keep that image. To be honest, but I have tried to break that image.
Okay.
Because I feel it's not necessary for people to be really scared of you. What is really required is that people have that respect for you, and they value you for the individual that you are.
And you are like, I mean, you obviously have a lot of experience in education. You said 30 years? You've been in 30 years?
Almost 30 years.
So how did it begin? How did you, from the childhood, say, I want to be a teacher one day, and then how did it happen?
I wouldn't say that from the childhood I had that. You can say that destiny got me into being a teacher. And I discovered that was the right place for me to be, because I've loved every bit of being a teacher, you know.
Please talk us through your journey. Like, how did it begin? What was your first job, and how did it lead to this current job?
Okay. So rather than starting from my job, I would start from me being a student. Just a little reference would help there. In 11th, when I had to change my school, I was made to join a certain school, which I didn't like. And because I wasn't comfortable there, so I kind of put my foot down and I said, I will change. You know, that was the first time that I wanted that, you know, whatever is mine, I should do. That's my calling. So I changed my school to modern, and incidentally, 7 years later, I joined there as a teacher. So
you became a teacher in the same school you were
yes,
a student.
Wow. Exactly.
In modern school,
in
which
modern,
is very well known. Yes.
Yes. So probably if I hadn't gone to that school, maybe my chances of being there would have been not so bright.
You started as a teacher and now as a principal. How many students in your school?
About 2,500.
Wow, that's a lot. Actually, I have something to show you. Let's have a look at the screen.
It's an amazing school. My journey since grade 3 and till now has been an amazing journey. At the same time, I have faced my challenges and overcome them with the help of my teachers. And I have got various opportunities, like being a part of the dance crew, getting chances in the MUN, being part of group discussions, guiding the junior ones with our skills, which we have been taught by our teachers. So it's an amazing journey.
One thing which I love the most about GD Goenka is that I've been in the school since 7th grade, and the love that the teachers give us, the support, the warmth that we feel, is something which I really cannot put in words.
I really love the way it
encourages us to participate in more activities and even gives us opportunities in academic area, like participating in Olympiads and even participating in MUNs. That's the biggest opportunity everyone gets in this school.
I have been in this school since 6th grade and we run to our principal ma'am for any small issue that we face. And we also go, you know, just for the tap on our back if we won any glory, whether small or big.
So when I joined the school, you know, when obviously as a new student, you're a bit nervous about how you're going to settle in. It's very easy to approach, whether it be your teachers or the higher authorities or the administration. They're always cooperative. So I think that is a big plus point for GD Goenka. Also, it was kind of experience we get over here. It's not just about academics, because these days, apart from academics, other skills are necessary as well, and not only wanted but necessary. So to get that, you know, we have on-hands training, we get on-the-field experience. So I think that really just enhances the kind of education system that we get over here.
In our school, teaching is a fun experience for me, honestly, because it's not just coming and walking into the class and talking to a group of students and giving them lectures and going away. It's a mix of a lot of methodologies, which makes it real fun for me.
So our principal, Ms. Anuradha Handa, I think what I would say is she's truly a student's principal, in the sense that it's one of the most common phrases you hear from her, that that she has an open door policy. So it's very easy to approach, whether it be any concern, whether it be achievement, you'll always find her beside you, whether it be supporting you or just listening to your concerns. So, and more than that, any authority figure needs to have this sort of a balance between sternness and friendliness. So I think she truly embodies that principle. And therefore, I wouldn't exactly call her strict or friendly. I would say it's a perfect mix of both.
Yeah, that's good, right?
Yes.
Okay. But you know, everybody has had a lot of people who have been part of the journey in these 30 years. Who are some of the people who really, like, you got inspired by, who guided you to do this?
So my first motivation comes from my husband.
Yeah.
So he's one person who's always pushed me to achieve my potential.
Wow.
So he stood by me. I did my master's in physics after my daughter was born. I got married immediately after my graduation. So with a 3-month-old baby, I did my master's.
And In physics.
From Delhi University.
Wow. And how many kids do you have?
One daughter.
One daughter. So I mean, you were a working mother. You are still a working mother,
yes.
Right? So how is that? I mean, is that difficult? I mean, a principal is a heavy job. I mean, it's not like chilling like a writer.
Yeah.
And then your mother also. How is that? Do you sometimes feel a conflict between taking care of other people's children versus your own child?
Not really. I think if you strike the right balance, being in teaching profession helped me strike that balance, because I could get those holidays with my daughter. So we enjoyed the summer break, the winter break, the weekends together, and we went to school and came back together. So that way I could strike a balance, and it's only when she moved out of school is when I moved into the positions of administration.
Oh, okay. So you waited.
Yeah.
And now that's it. Okay. Okay. On that note, we have someone on the screen for you.
शुरू से ही इसमें एक बड़ी स्ट्रॉन्ग डिज़ायर थी कि एजुकेशन के लिए कुछ नया, कुछ बड़ा किया जाए, और उसको लेकर शुरू से ही मैंने देखा कि इसने बहुत मेहनत की. जो प्यार, जो रिस्पेक्ट इसको बच्चों से, टीचर से, पेरेंट्स से एंड सोसाइटी से मिला, उन सब ने हम दोनों को ही मोटिवेट किया कि एजुकेशन में जो मैक्सिमम किया जा सकता है वो किया जाए.
मॉम, अ डायनामिक लेडी हु ऑलवेज बिलीव्स टू ब्रिंग आउट द बेस्ट इन एवरीथिंग. शी ऑलवेज स्टेट्स, से व्हाट यू डू एंड डू व्हाट यू से, एंड शी हैज ऑलवेज अप्लाइड दिस इन ऑल सिचुएशंस. यस, she is a lady of principles, is why probably she became a principal. Just kidding. Well, her sense of humor and timing is her strength. The best part is that even though she is at the peak of her career, nothing stops her from being humble and simple. When to this simplicity we add a tablespoon of humor, it becomes a deadly combination. She has the heart of gold and the mind of a gold medalist. In my eyes, she is a true leader, a born leader, because for her, it has never been I. It has always been we.
You know, to become somebody in the, what are the key things one requires to be an educationist? What are the key qualities in people, you know, like that make people a good educationist in your view? What does one need as a teacher, principal, a college, school, whatever?
Of course, you have to have a good sound knowledge of your subject. That goes without saying, because without that, you can't proceed. But that's not the only thing that you require. You should be able to connect. You should be able to win the confidence and trust of the children. Okay. They should feel confident and comfortable with you. I think that's more important as an educationist. Besides, so you should just not be like, you know, I've not been just a teacher. My children would just come and share anything and everything. And when I moved on from being a teacher.
They would tell you about their girlfriends.
Oh, yes. Absolutely. Wow. I mean, I still have.
Or the lack of girlfriends.
Both. And sometimes when they're getting stuck between two.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're like doing relationship, like.
I did that when I was a teacher. And now, of course, being a principal, there's a little more gap.
No, yeah. But as a teacher, like literally somebody say, I have a crush on two girls. Which one should I choose?
Yes. That's happened.
And if I may ask, how did you help them decide that?
After talking to him or the student. Wow, so especially being with 11th and 12th students, that's really desired to kind of.
And you were a physics teacher.
Then. I was a physics teacher. My children were always in my lab. I would never.
So you
I've
first
never
teach them Newton's laws of motion, and then about your girlfriend, how is she doing?
See, in physics, you have that stress strain graph. There is a lot of physics of relationships that I've thought about, which probably at some time I'll also come out with a book.
Yeah, now you're talking like, okay, I mean, GD Goenka is a brand in itself, you know.
Yes.
And, but why do you think that has been? What has helped make this institution become a great place to study? What is special about it?
GD Goenka focuses on the environment. See, at the end of the day, if children get an environment where they enjoy, where they are happy, where they get to do what they want to do, and it helps you discover your own inside innate passion. So if that's the kind of environment that you are able to give to children, obviously, you know, they would love to be a part of such an environment, and the brand would grow. And that's the strength of GD Goenka. It has a place where we have so many facilities, but more importantly, we call ourselves a school which is most modern in its outlook, but very traditional when it comes to human values. Okay. Just the two ends.
I mean, we can go on and on, but we have limited time. So, is there any message you have for the youth before we leave? Like, last thoughts, anything you want to tell the youth based on your rich experience of 30 years and now running a school?
I think what I would just like to say is that stay simplistic, stay grounded, stay approachable, move on the right path. Look for what your calling is, you know, definitely, you know, somewhere as a person, for example, you yourself as a professional moved from yes. being somewhere into definitely. Where your calling was. So if you are able to identify the calling early in life, you have a long way to go. And we have another program in our school that we've created for that, which I call as I Discover Me, IDM. So helping children go through that and giving them those. So I think whatever is close to my heart, if I get to do that, I love doing it day after day. And 30 years would also look like a short period, which has just gone by.
Okay. Well, I mean, you know, thanks. Those are wonderful messages and I hope people discover themselves. Thank you so much for coming. Before you go, we have this one little tradition, which is we take a picture and put it on our photo hanger, which we are developing. So we'll take a picture. I'll give you a small memento. And yeah, thank you so much for coming, ma'am. Come, we'll take a picture.
Yes.
Thank you.